The big supermarkets are accused of putting profits before health after a study found junk food is more heavily marketed in lower income suburbs. Researchers have told Justine Conway the data should force change at a time when it's most needed.
Marla Plimmen wants to feed her children the very best food she can.
I'd have to make sure that they have their brain food in the morning, a healthy lunch and a big hearty dinner.
She likes to shop at her local community market. There she can buy fresh produce at discounted prices and avoid the temptations of a regular supermarket.
Sometimes in the little mini fridges there are raspberry water, and I love raspberry water and it's really yummy. But I know it's not the healthiest.
Sugary treats have long been a fixture at the checkout. A new study of more than 100 supermarkets across Melbourne and Geelong confirms it.
90% of checkouts had some unhealthy food on display, so things like chocolates, lollies, sugary drinks.
Of the supermarkets analysed by Deakin University, 8 in 10 end-of-aisle displays featured junk food. But for researchers, the most concerning finding was that these selling tactics are most prevalent in lower socioeconomic areas.
We know that diet-related disease is much worse in areas that are less well off.
The proportion of shelf space allocated to unhealthy food and drinks was close to 10% higher in Braybrook and Sunshine, Broadmeadows and Laylaw, on the other side of Melbourne, Cranbourne and Springvale, and in Geelong, Corio and Newcombe.
Your health should not be dictated by your postcode or your income.
In response to the research, Coles, Woolworths and Aldi all highlighted their efforts to provide more healthy choices to customers. But those behind the study say that's not enough. There needs to be a change now. Our health has never been more important.
And these are families that have stuck by the supermarkets throughout this period, and it's time for supermarkets now to step up.
Justine Conway, Nine News.